Okay, my name is Mary Dzomo, the Chief Officer for Agriculture, Livestock, Fisheries and Cooperative Development, Transzoia County.
The country is losing about 40% to post-harvest loss. What options are we left?
What we have learned here today is that what farmers are losing can actually be contained if we follow the correct post-harvest practices. First of all, the farmers have to harvest maize. Let's say maize now, because it's the main focus now, as far as post-harvest losses are concerned. They should be able to harvest their maize at physiological maturity. That is at 38% moisture content. Because some of the losses that we incur is because of maize overstaying in the fields. So you encounter rotting because of too much moisture. Sometimes you have pest damage. Weevils, sometimes they attack the maize in the field when it stays too long. Sometimes we even have human pests through that. So first and foremost, farmers should harvest their maize at physiological maturity. They should invest in good storage, because one of the reasons why farmers lose a lot is because they don't have appropriate storage. So they should make sure they have good storage facilities. And at the same time, we have seen a technology here. We are calling it hematic bags. That is one technology that farmers can use to make sure that they don't lose as much of the produce as possible. Counties are investing in warehouses, because we know that farmers have a challenge with storage. Farmers can make use of these warehouses if they don't have adequate storage at home, where they can even aggregate their maize, do grading, sorting, and actually get a very good price in the market. Because you are saying when farmers aggregate their produce, they are able to market together, have collective bargaining, and get good prices in the market. At the same time, you are saying that the farmers, they should also dress the maize with appropriate chemicals, storage chemicals. The good thing is with the hematic bags is that you don't even have to use the chemicals. You can have the option of using the hematic bags or the metal silos, but you don't even have to use chemicals. But if you are not using those options, make sure you dress your maize with the appropriate chemicals so that it can last you for the whole duration of the year when there is no maize in the field.
Yeah. Follow me on.
Yes.
Research has been on this. Yeah. Yeah, the government even at some point appointed a committee, the ministry, to help look at the issue.
Yes.
The pesticides that the government recommended the farmers are saying are so expensive.
Mm-hmm.
How are we going to go about this?
Let me say that the fall armyworm is a very serious challenge for us now in the country. It should actually be declared as a national disaster. We have seen the pest this year, how it has behaved, and we know that it is just hiding somewhere and it will even strike for those areas who do the long race, just one crop. It has spread across the whole country. It came as a new pest, so by the time it came in, there was very little information about it or even what measures to use. But as counties, we have tried our best. We are encouraging farmers to use integrated pest management practices, not just use of chemicals, but even using traditional, or what we call indigenous knowledge, using biological, cultural. And we have even seen in some instances where we have seen BT maize is not being affected by this pest. So we are saying maybe it's time that the government now moved towards that policy where BT maize can now be used as one option to control the pest. But all is not lost, because come next week, that is on 7th and 8th of December, there is a National Fall Armyworm Symposium being hosted by Transzoia County. It will be at Karo, Kitale. This one has brought all the stakeholders on board, people from research, people from extension, people from companies, people from the NGO world. And together we are going to put our heads together. We are going to share experiences across what has happened across the year. We are going to look at what has worked and what has not worked, because like you have said, a lot of farmers were using chemicals, you know, left, right and center, because they were not sure what works and what does not work. So we are hoping that out of this symposium, apart from identifying the best control methods for the pest, we are also going to come up with affordable and simple solutions on how we can manage this pest. And I would say that because this is a concerted effort, we are going to strategize better so that come the next season, we'll be better prepared as a nation. The farmers will be better prepared. They'll have the information and they'll be able to use the information to make sure that they are able to tackle the pest as it comes to infest the crops.
Rod, this may not be under your docket, but is it not a factor contributing to the post-harvest
loss? Yes, I would say that poor infrastructure, and not just for maize, even for dairy produce, even horticulture produce, infrastructure, and not just roads. Even the infrastructure, we are talking of good markets, good maybe like cold rooms, good even coolers for the milk. It's a challenge. And you are saying that as partners now, because you have to partner. Agriculture needs to partner with the Department of Roads and Infrastructure, with the Department of Trade, so that together we can make sure that the infrastructure, that we open up production areas and make sure that the produce gets to the market in the best way possible and as quickly as possible is actually implemented. So it's a concerted effort.
The very last one. Your governor during the show was asking the national government to come and work on the roads to help use this for service loss thing.
Yes.
I don't know whether it may follow the national government, but can please make an initiative, especially in relation to the Ministry of Agriculture.
Now, you realize that there are three categories of roads in Kenya. There is the Kenha, the Kera, and the Kura. Yeah. So there are those roads, the rural access roads. Those are the ones the county government does. But you find that there are some major Kera and Kenha roads that fall within the national government docket that the national government needs to open up, so that even as we try to open up the rural roads that the county is supposed to work on, they are also connected to the major roads that lead to the main markets for the produce. So we really have to work together to make sure that the whole network across the county is operational. If one part of the government is not working, if you open the rural roads and we have the Kera and the Kenha roads not operational, we still not have solved the problem. So we need to come together as the two levels of government, so that we make sure that the whole infrastructure issue is working for the farmer.
Thank you so much for your
We have the fall armyworm, which is a new pest within the region. It's a new pest on the African continent, and it has the capacity to spread very fast, apart from the fact that it has very many alternative hosts. This is a challenge that we as governments, the national government, and all researchers and all people involved should take interest in very, very quickly, because it is bound to cost us very considerably. I'm sure all our governments are putting very high amounts of money and value to protecting our crops. This pest requires early intervention. The farmers must be able to identify, know that it's present early enough to be able to contain it in time. Two, it requires that you apply your chemicals properly and appropriately at the right place and at the right time. And finally, any farmer should be aware that the pest is basically here to stay, because it has so many alternative hosts that even after the crop of maize, it can survive on many other alternative hosts. So as we move into managing this pest together as county governments and the national government, I can assure you that if we do not look at it very carefully and do timely interventions, then the cost factors are going to be very considerable. We are told already that a considerable volume of our produce this year and part of last year was lost due to the fall armyworm. And this is a pest which, apart from being introduced in Africa only last year, I think, early last year, has already spread to nearly all countries from Kenya to the southern part of Africa in less than 12 months. So you can see how serious this problem is and how critical it is that our governments and our research institutions deal with the problem. So I would like to take this opportunity as the Deputy Governor of Busia. I didn't say my name. My name is Moses Mulomi. I'm born in Busia. I come from Butula sub-county. And as a person who has had exposure to agriculture also for many years, I would like to say that this encounter today with KEVS program is very, very appreciated. I sincerely hope that in future, the USAID program, through the various channels of development, will continue to sustain such programs to help our farmers and to help our communities improve their welfare.